Hi friends, this is the third problem in electric traction. Let's read the problem first. So, a 210 motor coach having four motors, each delivering 6000 Newton meter torque during acceleration, starts from rest. If up gradient is 30 ln 1000, gear ratio is 4, gear transmission efficiency is 90%, wheel radius is 45 cm, train resistance is 50 Newton per ton. So addition of rotational inertia is 10%. Now calculate time taken to attempt 50 kmph. So this is the speed. If line voltage is 3000 volt and efficiency of motor is 85%, find current taken during notching period by each motor. Okay, this is by each motor. This is the question. So we need to solve this question. So before go solving this question, the first point is calculation of time taken to attain 50 kmph. So how to solve this problem? So the time taken can be found out as speed has been given as 50 kmph. So the time is very simple. So we need to find time. Speed is equal to distance by time. So here, hello. So here, according to the data, we can find that we can use one formula. Tractive effort capital F is equal to eta capital T by Rw into gamma. Okay, that is formula from mechanics of train momentum, train movement. So from that we can take that formula and we can find the tractive effort capital F, and we can also find the tractive effort, total tractive effort, by using tractive efforts formula. So according to, by equating these two, we can find acceleration alpha. Once we find the acceleration alpha, we can, as we know the speed, so we can easily find out the time taken to attain 50 kmph. So that is the solution for the first problem. For the second problem, if line voltage is 3000 volt and efficiency of motor is 85%, find current taken during notching up period. So here we need to find the power. If we know the power, as power is equal to voltage into current, we already know the voltage 3000 volt, so we can easily find the current. And once we find the current, there are four motors, so we can find the current passing through each motor. So this is the solution for this entire problem. Let us see how we can solve this. First, let me take this as 1 and this is 2. To calculate first part, we need to find tractive effort F is equal to eta capital T by Rw into gamma, which is equal to eta means it's 90% gear transmission efficiency. So this is 0.9 into torque is 6000 Newton meter into, there are four motors, so 6000 per motor, so it should be into 4 divided by, the radius is 45 centimeters, so it should be 0.45, and gamma is gear ratio, that is 4. So these are the things we have incorporated for this formula. 4 motors are given, 6000 Newton meter torque has been given by each motor, so we need to multiply these two. And this is the efficiency, and this is Rw, this is the radius of the wheel, and 4 is the gamma. Okay, this is the thing. So if we do all these things by calculator, we get it will be 1,92,000 newton. This is for capital F. This is the tractive effort. So I can also calculate the tractive effort by using tractive efforts formula, that is 2.778 WE alpha plus 9.81 capital W capital G plus WR, where 2.778 WE is the effective weight, and that will be multiplied with addition of rotational inertia. So this is 10% is additive, so obviously it will be 1.1 times of W, where W is 200 into, I don't know alpha, of course I need to find out that alpha only, 9.81 into W is 200 into capital G is, the upgradient is 30 ln 1000, so it will be 30, plus W is 200 into R is this one, train resistance. R means it's the train resistance, 50 newton per ton. So 200 into W, it is 50. So these are the terms here. Once we equate these two, as these two are same and this part and this part are same, so once we equate these two, I can easily find out what is alpha. Therefore alpha is equal to, it comes around 2.01 kmph. This is the acceleration, so maybe kmph and ps will also be there. So I can find out time t1 is the, of course acceleration is equal to speed by time, so time is equal to speed by acceleration. So here I need to find out 50 kmph speed. So 50 divided by 2.01, it comes around 24.8 seconds. So this is the answer for the first problem. So according to data given, we have found out tractive effort by using this formula, by using mechanics of train movement formula, and after that FT by using tractive efforts formula, this is the thing, by equating these two I have calculated alpha. Once I found alpha, I can easily find out time t1. So this is the explanation for first part, and let us see the second part. Yeah, the second part is, we need to calculate the current passing through each motor. So to find current passing through each motor, I need to find the maximum power. Maximum power PT is equal to 0.278 FT VM divided by efficiency. So which is equal to, this is different efficiency, so this is 0.278 into FT is 192,000 into VM is, this is 50, it has been given like this, and the efficiency is the motor efficiency, so I need to take it as 85% efficiency of motors has been given as 85%, so it will be 0.85. so the power will be 3140 kilowatt. This is the power I have received. So now it's very easy for me to take the current drawn. I is equal to power P by V, so it is 3140 divided by 3000, is equal to into 1000, because this is in kilowatt. this is in kilowatt, so I need to make it 1000. So it will be 1047 ampere. Therefore, current passing through each motor will be 1047 divided by 4, which is equal to 261.75 ampere. This is the current passing through each motor. So this is the solution for two bits. So the first bit is time required to attain 50 kmph, and the second bit is current passing through each motor. So if you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video with your friends and colleagues, please share it, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. To get the notifications, please press the bell button. Thank you. Thank you very much.